There's so much change, it's like we're in a blizzard. As we go forward, there isn't going to be one institutional form. I think there are going to be characteristics that describe post-secondary education. I think we're entering a time where reflection, learning how to extract meaning from your experience, whether it's a formal learning experience or an informal personal learning experience. In other words, I did this. Now, what did I learn? How did it change me? Who am I today that I was not before I started? So you're going to see real emphasis on those kinds of things, evidence, and you're going to see much less large group learning and much more small group and individual learning, where learning support, advice, counsel, whether it is technologically based or human, or in all likelihood both, is going to become as central as the lecturer used to be central. So we're shifting, I think the whole paradigm is shifting towards a support environment as opposed to a one-person teaching many environment. There are two answers to the question of the value of a degree in today's economy. On the one hand, it is abundantly clear that people who have a baccalaureate degree live longer, participate more actively in the economy, earn more, vote more, and so from a point of view of the meta question, is a degree valuable, the answer is, of course it is. Now, on the other hand, is a degree, you know, valuable today? There's an article in USA Today I saw very recently in which they are saying that if you live in a certain place and there's a particular job you want, you can make a lot of money, earn a good living, and do so with very focused training courses at the community college level or sub-baccalaureate level. So I think what's happening is that we are seeing the degree in a different way. Increasingly, it should reflect a choice that people make, as opposed to be seen as a requirement for entry into the kingdom. In order for someone to recognize and accept that learning, the knowledge, skills, and ability that a person has or is claiming to have are valid is because they can be verified. We're leaving a time where it was because I say so. So we would have people get a degree, and then because the college said so, they were deemed ready for employment. We're now finding increasingly employers saying they may be ready to graduate, but they're not ready to work. They're asking for, as are the funders of higher education, and I think K-12, looking for better forms of and kinds of evidence that in fact something of value is happening in this transaction called, you know, teaching and learning. Either the employer, him or herself, is going to validate the learning and satisfy themselves ultimately, or they're going to need context. I think the real issue is who's got the evidence, how can they display the evidence, and is that add up to success in the workplace or success in school?